far things were quite simple. Now let's start with one of the most interesting part of integration, which is integration by parts. Okay. This is synonymous with the product rule that you have in integration. Not exactly in the same way as we had in differentiation. So first let us know this rule. What is this rule? So this rule says that if you want to integrate product of two functions, u and v, where both u and v are functions of x, then the rule is u times integral v dx minus integral of du by dx times integral v dx dx. Okay. This rule is known as integration by parts. First of all, let us derive it. The derivation of this is actually influenced by the product rule that you have in differentiation. So if you want to find the derivative of product of two functions, let's say f of x and g of x, we know that by product rule it is f times derivative of g of x plus g times derivative of f of x. Okay, now let's say u is your f of x and v is your derivative of g of x. Is that okay? If v is the derivative of g of x, can I say that g of x would be integral of v with respect to x? Correct? Now let us substitute these two in this expression. So we'll have v by dx of f of x is u. G of x is integral of v dx equal to f of x is again u, in derivative of g of x is v, plus g of x, I can write this as du by dx into integral of v dx. So this term is du by dx because f of x is u, and this term is integral of v dx. Is that okay? Take the dx on the other side. And integrate both sides. Okay. What's the integral of d of something? That something, correct? This let it be as such. And this will become integral of du by dx into integral v dx with respect to x. Now make this the subject of the formula. You will get integral u into v dx as u times integral v dx minus integral of du by dx times integral v dx with respect to x. And this is the formula that we derived over here. Knowing the derivation is not important, but however, knowing the result is very, very important. This formula is called the formula of integration by parts. So in the next half an hour or so, we'll do some basic application of this formula. I'll start with one simple example. But before that, one quick analysis of this formula. Okay, a quick analysis of this formula says, in this entire formula list, u is never getting integrated. Do you see that?
Yeah.
U either remains u or it is differentiated. And actually a very important message that this formula gives. The message is, when you have given two functions, u and v, u should be the one which is difficult to integrate. Always choose u as that function which is difficult to integrate. And v as that function which is relatively easier to integrate. Okay? Now, who decides which is difficult and which is easy to integrate? In 1994, there was a guy called Herbert E. Kasube. Okay. Not Kasube. Okay. This guy gave a rule called Liat. Now, later on, we find that Iliat also works fine. What is this rule? This rule says that to decide which function is difficult to integrate, you follow the simple mnemonic. The mnemonic says, first of all, let me tell you what does this word stand for, Liat or Iliat. L stands for logarithmic functions. I stands for inverse functions. Let me write it down somewhere. So in his research work, he said that functions should be chosen as u and v in the following priority list. First of all, L stands for logarithmic functions. I stands for inverse trig functions. A stands for algebraic functions. T stands for trigonometric functions. And E stands for exponential functions. So he said that higher the function in that list, that function should be chosen as u. This is the most difficult to integrate. This is the most easiest to integrate. Okay? So let's say you are given a function where one is algebraic and other is exponential. Which one will you choose as u?
Algebraic.
Automatically we will become the exponential function. Okay? In some books they say the rule is Iliat. However, it doesn't make much of a difference because I and L are equally difficult to integrate. Okay. So I'll start my example by integrating one of the standard functions which we never integrated. Log x. Okay. So all the functions mostly we have seen the integration, but this function is something which we haven't touched upon yet. Now I will be using integration by parts to integrate it. But wait, you will think, where is the other function?
One,
right? Take it as one. If there is nothing, jiska koi nahi uska, one to hota, correct? Yes, sir. So take one as the other function. Now, one is an algebraic function and log is a log function. So take this as u, take this as v, correct? According to the Iliat or Liat, whichever rule you want to follow. Now, let's apply the formula of integration by parts. So u times which is ln x, integration of v. What is integration of 1? X. Okay. Minus integration of. Integration of what? Integration of product of du by dx and integration of v dx. So what is du by dx? 1 by x. Into integration of this is x. Now please do not put a constant of integration in between and all. Okay. We'll put it towards the end. This we have to integrate with respect to x. Correct? So indirectly you are integrating what? 1 with respect to x. So your answer is going to be x log x minus integration of 1 which is x plus c. Going forward. Going forward, please remember this result. Integral of log x or ln x. Log x to the base c is x times log x minus 1. This result should be well known to you. Please include this in the formula list wherever you are maintaining it. Okay. This also gives me an opportunity to talk about integral of inverse trig functions which we have never seen so far. We know the differentiation of sine inverse, but we never integrated sine inverse. We know the differentiation of tan inverse, but we never integrated tan inverse. Right? We know the differentiation of sec inverse, but we never integrated sec inverse. So my first
integration by bar.
Bar.
No, he gave highlight.
He gave the highlight rule to decide. Good. It was not invented, it was logically driven like this. Now who was the first person to do that? But it must have been done much earlier. This fellow just came with the rule. Now who was the first person to do x squared by x is x? That I don't know. Can I do this? Individuals know applications, they don't know the history. Okay.
So we like the transition.
Integrate the following. I would not ask cos inverse because if you know this, you know cos inverse also. So basically the three inverse trigonometric function. I am purposely not asking you to integrate cos inverse because if this is known, cos inverse is known. If this is known, cot inverse is known. If this is known, cosec inverse is known. We don't need the fan actually. If you're done with the sine inverse x, you can share your answer with me.
X sine inverse x plus 1 by 2 ln 1.
No?
X sine inverse x minus
x inverse.
Under root 1 by 2. X sine inverse x plus under root 1 minus x squared plus c is the answer for sine inverse. Okay, now there are various ways to do it. I'll show you both the ways. One way to solve the problem is simple. If you don't know the other function, take it as 1. Okay. So this is of course u, this is of course v. So according to the integration by parts formula, it's u times integral of 1 which is x minus derivative of sine inverse x which is this into x dx. In this you can take 1 minus x square as t square. So minus x dx will be t dt, right? So x dx is minus t dt. So minus x dx will become t dt by t. Okay. So this will give you x sine inverse x plus t. And t is under root 1 minus x square. So this is the answer for integral of sine inverse x. Remember the result if possible. If possible. X sine inverse x plus under root 1 minus x square plus c. This is one way to do it.
There's another way to do this.
Yeah. We'll discuss.
Suppose you can assume sine inverse x as something.
Alright. You assume sine inverse x to be an angle theta. That's another way to do it. Meanwhile, have you copied this? Vishak? Vishali? So, sine inverse x, you assume it to be theta, which implies x is sine theta, which implies dx is cos theta d theta, right? When you substitute here, you write it as theta cos theta d theta. Now, even though it is theta, you can treat that as x cos x dx in your mind. Okay, doesn't make much of a difference. Now this is behaving as an algebraic function, this is behaving as a trigonometric function. So which one will you take as U? The algebraic function. LIAT, A comes first. Now apply IVP over here. So U times integral of cos x is, cos theta is, sin theta, minus d theta by d theta, which is 1 integral of cos theta is sin theta. Please note the x will not change to theta here. The rule will be the same. Instead of saying u integral v dx, you will say u integral v d theta minus integral of du by d theta into integral v d theta whole with respect to theta. Now very simple, what is integral of sin theta minus cos theta? So you will get cos theta. Now please note, you cannot leave your answer in theta because theta is something which you assume, replace it back. So theta is sin inverse x and sin theta is x, so it will become x sin inverse x. And we all know what is cos of sin inverse x. Make that triangle thing and find your answer.
So what is
this? This is another way.
Huh?
X tan inverse x minus half ln 1 plus x squared. Second one, who will come and do it on the board? Sumit, will you come and do it on the board? You come. Come. You don't mind facing the camera. Not camera shy. So, Nikhil is solving integral of tan inverse x.
Outside because so he comes before the secret, I think that's the secret.
Without that, you cannot solve the problem.
It's the paper.
Oh, yeah.